Welcome back to Kansan to Kansan. Today, we celebrate the 100th anniversary of the ratification of the 19th Amendment. The centennial celebration is a reminder that Kansas was a leader in the women's rights movement from the start, including being the first state to hold a referendum on women's suffrage. This brought the issue directly to the people for a vote. Although this first referendum failed, it did lay the groundwork for voting rights in Kansas and states across the country. In 1887, the Kansas legislature granted women the right to vote in municipal elections. It took no time for the people of our state to make history, when that April, voters in Argonia elected the first female mayor in the nation, Susanna Salter. In 1912, Kansans approved the Equal Suffrage Amendment to the state constitution, making Kansas the eighth state to grant women full suffrage. Kansas women went on to play a critical part in passing the National Suffrage Amendment. Now, 100 years later, we celebrate those women and men who worked tirelessly to make our country an equitable home. As we reflect on our history and the struggles we have overcome in the fight for progress and equality, it's worth pausing and appreciating the history we have made this year at the ballot box as well. For the first time, we have a vice presidential candidate of a major party who is a woman of color, and in Kansas, all the congressional Democratic candidates are female. Having women on the ticket is about more than just representation. It's a symbol for our sisters, our daughters, our nieces, and our grandchildren to see and recognize that they could be there one day. So when you vote this November, I encourage you to remember those who fought to make it possible. We stand on their shoulders. See you next time on Kansan to Kansan.